Good morning, all. How you guys doing? So I'm not doing raids this morning because I slept in, but it was important that I slept in because God, my hair's a mess. Because I wasn't sleeping that well recently, and freaking, I need my beauty sleep, or I grow unhealthy, and unhealthy is not good. So let's go live and figure out what I'm doing today. So yeah, usually at this time I should be like I'm Vaughn 5 and 6. So I do Project Nemesis, Killing Time, and Vaughn 5 and 6 on Saturdays starting around 10 p.m. Pacific to 1 p.m. Eastern, like 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 on West Coast, 1 on the East Coast, but I had to sleep in because I wasn't performing good. So I had to take responsibility of my body. No one's hitting LFM yet. I'm just going to go ahead and get this started. Yesterday I was thinking today would be a good day to do a saga. Because sagas are delicious and quite nutritious. And when I'm in the dungeon, I feel quite vicious, yeah. Welcome. Welcome. I think that's all my... Might as well put that up. Hello.
Visitor Norman waits for you near the entrance. An irritated
scowl
on his face.
Hello, Kick. Alright, gonna bust up this organization. Show them I'm the... not to do any tax evasion. Hey, no. I still don't have all my spells in my thing, but I think I'll do well with what I'm rocking. Ooh! It's just R1, guys. Their souls? Our souls. I'm level 8. Well, I got a rock. Congratulations on being level 6. Yeah, sadly, because I'm doing R1. I should just do EE, but I figured I might as well do R1 this time around. Cultist, get out the way. Get out the way, Colt. Get out the way. Oh no, I'm about to fire your lights out. Hey. Luda. My homie Ludacris. He don't know me, but he's my homie. No! 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 Oh no, 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 no! Oh no! Bam! Get the fuck out of here. Pest control's in the house. Who the fucks are you, Bastion? You should be Sebastian, because I'm about to play you like a keeper. Sebastian Bach. Because you're so 80s and I'm so hot. Hey. Thank you. If you guys want to do the optionals, go ahead. But I'm moving forward.
The novice who accompanied Noman lies on the ground in the hallway ahead.
Welcome to the Nymphin Dursing Show. I got calling, never fall, balling. Senior cultist. Hello, I'm the senior cultist. I've been worshiping this false idol for many years. Back in my day, it was a religion. These kids nowadays, they're cults and they're etch-a-sketches and... Every time I'm doing a quest or a actual pen and paper game where I'm fighting against cultists, I always, the visual in my head is the Arnold Schwarzenegger's movies with you know, Conan the Barbarian, right? Because, like, a lot of the things that he fights are these really crazy and visually super Dungeons & Dragons TSR decade cultist-like layers. And it was really beautifully done. If you're a D&D player, please watch Conan the Barbarian movies starring Arnold Schwarzenegger. They're super appeasing to your Dungeons & Dragons senses. They're so freaking Dungeons and Dragons, it's crazy.
In the center of this room stands a bloodstained altar.
It's so amazing that, you know, out of anyone, it's freaking Arnold Schwarzenegger that plays the most Dungeons and Dragons like barbarian ever. But then again, Conan's been part of the Dungeons and Dragons inspiration since the 1970s. Like, if you have the original AD&D books, there's a list of inspirations, and Conan, what's his face in the Grey Mauser, there's just so much inspiration. What? You break when I'm at you. When I'm at you, you break. So, break. Hey, cultist, calm down. You need to simmer down now. Oh, you want to fight? That's what I thought. It's like what I thought, man. Like, back the fuck up, dude. Me and Scooby-Doo are totally gonna fuck you up, man. Oh. Tim Finnegan was a Irishman. He was very Irishy. He hadn't been back like for a while. Let's just go.
Visitor Noman stands next to a strangely confident looking drow.
All right, so next is servants of the Nimlords. So this actually has a lot of Eberron lore in it. The Lords of Dust and all that are See,
Okay,
Kyber is one
continue.
of the places of Eberron, and it's also one of the progenitor dragons, the progenitor dragons. And from him came the first demon lords, Spinner of Shadows and all that, and pretty much the first people. And from so there was celestials and demons in this world, and devils, without there actually being hells and you know what I mean, like matter of fact, Keith Baker said in multiple times there's no like actual gods and stuff in this world. So this is a place where it naturally has celestials, demons, and devils, and Patrick Swayze. It's my dick in the box. Dick in the box, girl. Hey, caress. You can caress my balls, and if you hit me hard enough, I'll crash your walls. Yeah. Omnivin. Don't give in. Delayed fireball comet. Meteor swamp. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, I be tanking. I be tanking. No, I'm just kidding. This is why I'm not an official fan site DDO streamer, because I say crass my balls on my freaking live stream. How many of you left after that? Oh no, you guys are still around. Let's see what we got. Oh, Reaper 3. And they already left, so. Harass these nuts. No, I'm in fire elemental form, right? It's toggled, but because someone stone skinned me, I don't know. It visually shows to me that I'm not. To other people, I'm flamed on like fuck. Like, damn. No, I'm just kidding. Oops, go ahead and go in. I accidentally stepped into the Spinner of Shadows prison. Yep. In on our one, in our all fun, gonna get a full ass up. Someone told me that my rapping is crapping, but I'm here crafting a new thing, napkin folding. Yeah, this is me molding. Yeah. Hip, pass the pipe to me, token. Hey, you know. I want these collectibles. I want your collectibles. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't it feel good? R3 Ravenloft hurts. Yeah. Actually, I find in Legendary side that Ravenloft is one of the
Blood-stained air fills its
easier
chamber as the
ones
stone
to
door
do.
slides
Like,
open.
R7 Ravenloft is quite standard for me. But that was prior to the Reaper changes. I hadn't really done Reaper Ravenloft in a while. And lately, I've been really enjoying R4 because, one, it's a little easier than I used to do, and it has no new Reapers in it, so it tends to be faster. And as long as I make over 400,000 RXP per life, I call that a success. Because one, I need like 220,000 or 210,000 to get a Reaper point where I'm at. So if I can get a point per life or 2 points per life, I'm happy. You know what I'm saying? I also have videos of me doing soloing some of the quests in there on a barbarian fighter Asimar or something. I forgot. It's in I did some solos basically. One solo quest, the Wizards of the Wines on R3, I believe. And have a whole series of Nymdas Ravenloft, which, mind you, RL4 and Nymdas Sharn is coming up pretty soon. So if you don't follow my YouTube channel, you probably should, because it's about to get spicy in content. But Nim, I don't know your YouTube channel. YouTube. Boom. Type in exclamation mark tube and you get it. If you do exclamation mark commands, you get a list of commands that will give you links.
Flickering torchlight illuminates a curiously well-worn path.
He go to the right, I go straight ahead. And I play the fiddle and I do a little diddle and then I hang out with Kid Rock. Man, Kid Rock. His career's wild. I'm not a huge fan of his music. I'll say it to his face, but man, do I have respect for his cameos. If you watch a lot of good movies and good TV shows and stuff, he'll fucking throw himself in there somewhere. And he's really easy to hide too. Like, he has one of those faces that if you just put like us just different wigs or whatever around him, he's so easy to hide. And so I just mad respect for the cameos. I'm not saying he's an awful music creator. I'm just it's not really my taste. The new wave of a southern party, whatever you want to call it. Drinking whiskey in a bottle, humping my Bible, getting up inside to the and I say, Lulu, I'm Kid Rock. Well, what if Kid Rock, one of you guys are Kid Rock and you're like, hey man. That's not how that line goes. I don't hump my Bible, I read my Bible. Welcome.
Hey.
Hey man, that's offensive. Burp, burp, derp, derp, burp. Every time I hear his music, I think of Burger King too. I don't know why. Burger King, Whopper, Pepsi. Wait, Whopper is McDonald's, right? Or is that Burger King? Can someone help me? I'm going insane. I'm freaking going crazy here. And I blame Kid Rock. So I got a desk lamp so that way I can get my lighting better, right? But the thing doesn't freaking, the light bulb doesn't work. So I don't know what I'm gonna do about that. I probably should just invest in a light bulb next month. Because you guys need to see all my pores. And it's funny, I'm poor and I have pores.
Where are you guys? I'm pretty sure that wherever the nether realms of Kyber are, I don't want to be there.
Yeah, technically, Kyber is a giant dead dragon. So, like, it would be in her nether.
Nethers?
But it's a girl dragon, so, like, I guess it's okay.
Nah, I don't care.
I'm batting around the idea of doing like an Eberron lore video series for YouTube. So that way, like, well, one, it'll help the pen and paper players of DDO, but two, it would also, there's a lot of content here that is very inspired if you know a little, just a little bit of the lore.
Uh-huh.
There's also some content that you kind of like, well, if the Lord of Dust are like super powerful demons from the first age, then why are they just CR-16? Yeah.
You lose your edge when you're in jail for that long.
Well, the Rakshasas, Keith Baker says that there's no actual physical, there's no gods. There's you can get your divinity powers through in this world through faith. But the closest thing to a god in Eberron is a Rakshasa. And the first Rakshasas, or the first demon lords, if you will, of this world, were the Spinner of Shadows and all the other Lords of Dust. They were produced from the carcass of Kyber. They were the first living entities on Eberron. So, if they're basically the closest thing to a walking, breathing god on this planet, then why am I knocking them out so fast? Well, you see, though it's only recently have their stuff been, since they got exposed to Keith Baker in the Sharn expansion, have they actually started figuring stuff out. Like, the latest Sharn pack is kind of, like, retconning how Warforged, like, it... Because, you know, you see Warforges all the time, and no one's like, hey, dismantle that piece of shit. Which most people in Eberron are like, because it's like imagine World War II, right? And then all of a sudden, nuclear bombs get their own rights, and they're riding around like trying to apply the same jobs as you. And you're like, wait, that thing, like, is a war machine. We invented it from the last war. Why, you know what I mean? Like, why is it considered a living thing? And that's how ever most people treat Warforges, is either as tools or painful memories of the last war, which obliterated one of the nations, and that's where you get the Bornlands. It's a whole nation that turned into a toxic nuclear waste zone. So, you know, there's that one quest, right, where the Warforges are having throwing a rally, right? And then a bunch of humans are...
Yep.
So you see the Keith Baker came in the office on the expansion, and they're like, oh, we got all of that wrong. Like, this one here has a big flaw. There's a silver flame in there. The only time the silver flame has ever shown up on Eberron is in Sire, when the religion began, because this woman, paladin, warrior, cleric, it's basically the Silver Flame is like the Jedi, right? They have a group of beliefs, and if they uphold these beliefs, they get powers, you know, divine powers. And it started because this chick was fighting this war, right? And she, right before she died, she gave, like, a devastating blow, and where she died, there's a giant silver flame. That's why it's called the Silver Flame. Because of one instance. So the idea that there's a talking silver flame guardian here is kind of like, really? Someone wasn't reading their books.
The spinner of shadow struggles against her weakening bonds, while below her, the spiders consume the last.
So I was thinking it would be interesting to make like a little lore series, so that way I want you to love me. Can I get cigarettes? That was my mama. And these are tacos brought to you by mama. It's so good.
Destroy these intruders, my lady. One of the Rakshasas growls.
Isn't that weird that that thing came out of a dragon? A dead dragon?
Shadow screams and scuttles back into the darkness. You feel her grasp on you.
Now the funny thing is the Sovereign Host, right?
Hold, demon.
Because Keith Baker, he's like, there's no cleric of Oron. They're like, all clerics of the Sovereign Host worship all the deities, even the Dark Six. Because the Dark Six represents civilization, while the Sovereign Host represents nature. So you need all of them. So, in DDO, they made the Dark Six kind of like look evil. But, like, if you look into them, the Traveler isn't that much of a horrible entity. It's actually more like happy-go-lucky. But he's wild, man. He represents jazz, free will. But they've never physically manifested, nor have they, nor do any of the clergy actually believe they exist. They just have faith in their representation. So, like, the divinity sense is all faith-based. And so the celestials and demons, like those celestials, those angel divas that we see, right? Those are actually natives. Those are one of the first natives of Eberron. So these three dragons just naturally produced demons, devils, and celestials. I brought up how we should have Corvarian goblins as a player race next. And everyone got upset with me. They were like, hey, you know, kobolds. I'm like, well, first of all, what the hell kobolds ever did in Eberron? Second of all of Corvair used to be a goblinoid nation with orcs being the nomadic druidic order because there's no Grumsh, right? The orc god. So they're more primitive, not primitive, but primal. And the goblins, basically in pen and paper, if you go find a magic sword in a ruin, that's a goblin's magic sword, and that's a ruin of a goblin nation. So the goblins have this hatred for humans and elves and all these things because they're basically thriving off of a society, land and society stolen from them in Eberron. And I find like, oh, and then we have goblins now, right? So I was like, dude, we should totally do goblin next. That would be the most sensible player race in an Eberron based game. Hello, we're in Spinners of Shadows. I forgot to change the LFM because I'm eating tacos.
All you had to say was tacos.
Yeah.
A feeling of dread overwhelms you, as if darkness has entered your very soul. The Spinner of Shadows.
Queso con tacos. We're supposed to bring her in the middle a third, the second time, and then do the optional.
Come for me, my sister, cries the Spinner of Shadows.
Yeah, I wasn't lying. I was distracted by tacos. Decides to change tactics. Arise, girls gotta eat, right? You guys are literally watching me eat. Now that's a fetish. There's also the smoking fetish, like, those trip me out. I'm like, because people eat and smoke all the time, right? Oh, we probably should save the Silver Flame because he's the one cure for the spider poison. Besides dying, we can always just die as those dots increase.
The Silver Flame, the swarm of spiders subsides, and the Guardian is once again safe. Time for you to finish relighting the walls.
Oh, he's dead.
Chuckles in the shadows. An amusing game, mortals.
Alright, just don't get bitten by spiders, guys. You'll be fine. To avoid comp. Okay, one last taco. Can he do it? Can he finish it? It shouldn't matter anymore because the spiders are spawning. The Silver Flame's already dead. So at this point, we should be just mad collecting crystals. There's no way to make her vulnerable through the center now because we didn't do the optional. Yeah, just grab a taco and just chill, bruh. We'll work on this. Tacos. Beyond the Rift is next. You're all welcome to stay. I like it when people are willing to do the further ones first. Move, demon! Get out the way! Get out the way! Whoa, these don't even work on her anymore. There we go.
No, Ma.
Yep. Get out of Grove Street! Grove Street! We are the champions! So this is the interesting part, right? Is that she's a demon lord from Ebron who was one of the first things that produced of the carcass of Kyber. And she's going to be swallowed by a celestial demon lord, Loth, who was stricken down by Quirlin Lorithian during the beginning years of Tor-Ril. One's basically the evil goddess of elves. The other one is just the equivalent to, like, a secretion or a fungus.
Where you are, neutralize the spinner of shadows. The drow wronged it to me, just as you said they would. What shall I do with these irritated mortals?
Leave them alone, Lord commands. The demon web will soon swallow this place and them along with it. Now, bring me the dragon shards. There is much to do.
And that's trippy. If you read Spelljammer, all little planets or plane campaign settings are protected by this like weird sphere, right? That you can like spelljam through. So like, at what point in time did anyone ever tell Lolth about dragon shards and their like psionic powers given to him by the progenitor dragons? I think we need a Menace of the Underdark part 2 to explain like how the hell any of this works. Really, what the story that I've been hearing for this expansion is that this wasn't the expansion we asked for, but since 4th edition D&D came out, they wanted to promote a lot of 4th edition, and so we got in Forgotten Realms, not by choice, but by promotion. Hey, Melody. Sweet, I'll be right there. A Leinster drives me crazy. Ah, strangers, methinks. Not used to the rift, I see. I am Elminster. I'm looking for the Red October. Give me a second, I don't think I turned it in because it's not giving me the window. I'll be right there in a second.
Court's just super laggy.
Some good shit right here. Oof. Some good shit. Oof. Oof. Some good shit. Some white gummy bear shit, yo. Some white gummy bear shit, yo. Yeah, it's probably laggy as hell. Because I just got the window and I'm in the middle of freaking town. And it let me enter from the middle of Evening Star.
This rift, her sister, the magic shards she's plundered from your
world. This rift.
They are all part of
some
vast and tangled scheme of Lolth's.
It's a scheme from Lolth.
Lolth now wages war on the kingdom of Cormyr in a little village named Evening Star. This rift, that war, are bound together in her plan.
It's part of Lolth's
so
plan.
I suspect.
I'm a Leinster.
I sense that she has dropped a guard again. Occupied with
no.
Sister, most
can I have some?
I must leave while I can. Find thy way to Evening Star.
I didn't even go over there.
It is a dangerous journey, but you seem to be accustomed to dangerous journeys.
Elminster departs. The demon web sprawls out before you. Somewhere in this chaotic maze lies the path to the place Elminster called Evening Star. The hunched creatures ahead make some strange and disgusting sounds as they root through old bones. They produce even more disgusting smells.
I'm prison rich. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, I hate my life. Alright. House of Nim my ass. All cause you're not eligible to go into all the rooms doesn't mean it's dead. Like I told you this last time, Thotgore. There's a section for High Lords only. I have my own studio where I can. I only. That I have where I can only. I only let specific people in so that way I can stream uninterrupted. I have. And that's it. So I added those rooms and then. So it's not my fault that the rest of the members aren't in general chat. The most of the people who are active in there is just me and Toxicoma, really. And I'm fine with that. People are leaving the Discord all the time. I don't give a fuck. I ain't got time to, like... Freaking, I didn't even have time to run my Saturday morning raids. Like, I don't have time to appease everyone. If you can't appease yourself, then don't expect my hand to reach down and appease you. That ain't my job. Do I look like your mom? Fucking get your needs elsewhere, bruh. I got needs myself. Fucking shit. The house of Nim is empty because it's my house. I ain't got no family. I don't got a wifey up in there. I don't got kids up in there. I'm a single ass man, and it's empty because it's my house.
A spider hatchery lies empty.
I can walk around my boxes up in that bitch.
Then dispersed into the fragments of long forgotten worlds lie ensnared in Lolth's web. This will be the fate of Eberron.
Ooh, I hit the wrong button. I wanted to save that energy burst for later. Again, all the other platforms I'm streaming to are empty and dead right now. Like, I don't even know why I do Facebook and all that. Like, I actually enjoy doing YouTube because... it posts the video afterwards, so I have a catalog. I don't know how to do VODs on Twitch. Friggin. This is the closest we ever gotten to lesbian sex in this game. And it's sad, and we should get more. So fucking hot. Magical energy. For an instant you stand transfixed by the soul seed. Then wow, that was some bad clipping there though. Like she was all the way up there and then bam. Then bam. Mexico is not even on right now. See, I'm just gonna. Oh, and I have a room for me and Scotty to do our little podcast, which we hadn't been doing because that fool's life is getting on.
Ahead lies a glimmering magical portal. You have no way of knowing what strange new world it leads to, but at least it will take you away from the demon. You find yourself in a vast cavern of stone deep below the surface. If you are to find Elminster, you must traverse.
Ah, yeah. Now, the Underdark. The Underdark. This place is supposed to be like... some end game shit, or the leading to some end game shit, because you can lead into some demon lords through the Underdark, some real demon lords. We're talking about Orcus and all, but you know that the Abyss or the Elemental Chaos can has tears and portals to almost everywhere, but the Underdark seems to be kind of like where they leak through into our plane of existence, which you know, gives us the elements that we have on our plane of existence. Tox likes me too. Tox is a cool guy. I like Tox a lot. I like playing pen and paper with Tox a lot, and he knows this. I'm glad that Toxicoma has validates you. No one dislikes you. Well, I don't dislike you. You know that. I just don't, you know, I can't be sitting here validating people for, like, I have my own issues too, you know? You know, if I was a therapist or a psychologist and I was getting paid like hella money to validate people, I'd do it. But I'm not. It's not my job. It's not what I'm on Earth for. Honestly, I'm pretty sure as soon as I get kicked out of this house, I'm probably gonna end up being a homeless bum and like OD on some drug and die. So this is just me documenting my last happy moments on Earth, and I'm not even that happy.
Three drow scouts are talking on the ledge above. A magical portal lies ahead. With the scouts of light, it will take you closer to the surface. The drow patrol you saw before is taking a break on the other side of the ravine.
You know, I give out this message to self-forgive, self-parent, and self-love. Because, really, when you seek healing through others, you increase your chances of being disappointed. It really, because a lot of everyone's hurt. Everyone's going through something. And they all need the same thing. And they can't get it from someone who needs, but someone who receives and gives. You know what I mean? When you know, it's different. But when you need, like I told this to one of my ex-girlfriends, like, I don't want to be needed, I want to be wanted. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to feel like I'm your crutch in life. I don't want to feel like your babysitter. I don't want to feel like the nipple that you suck on. I want to feel like your favorite video game. I want to feel like your favorite pillow. I want to be your favorite memory. I don't want to be a need. I don't want to be what sustains you. You should be able to handle yourself when I'm away. You have to be able to self-forgive, self-parent, and self-love. And it's really hard to do. And it's such an alien concept. It's such a silly thing to hear when you don't understand. But when it clicks, and when it all comes together, it becomes this journey with yourself. A self that you manifest within yourself to take care of yourself. Because it's easier to look at someone else and take care of someone else and their needs when you're so vulnerable. But if you manifest your inner turmoil as an inner self, then hopefully you can look at yourself as you do other hurt people and reach out to yourself and give yourself what you need, which is the love, the forgiveness, the understanding, and the wisdom that you give others. Because I was talking about this with a guildie yesterday. And my guildie reads a lot of books from certain authors that talk about what I talk about. And it's so funny hearing that there's like all these authors and psychologists telling people about this stuff. This stuff that I found out on my own over a week of being depressed over an ex. It's this, it's really nice to know that I found a truth within myself that is an actual... Good to see you too. Alright, Chain 1 of Menace of the Underdark is next. You're all welcome to stay. I'm going to put the LFM up for that. See it. Oh, Gary left. Don't mind if I do. Everyone leaving.
You say level 27 is okay for this, Nim?
Yeah. It's a 6 over.
Okay.
Thank you. I was just heading over to get that. That pot, you'd be surprised how much pot I don't smoke. I think I smoke about 1 to 3 days out of a month. This here is white gummy bear, fluid. It's really light on nicotine. You could tell because of how light it is, but this is what I puff on. When I, this is what I puff on when I don't want to take you guys out for a cigarette. Here I am, in King's Forest again. Here I go, up on the stage. Here I am, on the road again. Here I go, turn the page. Chapter 2, How I Got Stuck on a Fence. I know a guy that you would love. My cousin was dating this guy that was obsessed with pineapple. He had pineapple uva, or hookah, as you Americans call it. Freaking pineapple juice, pineapple slices. Like, everything in his house was pineapple and Netflix. And I was just sitting here, like, he didn't understand English too well. So I was just sitting there clowning on him to my cousin. I'm like... do you want to sit on my pineapple sofa and watch Netflix? Yes.
Where is it? The priest is gone. Do not play games, fool.
I don't know, man. My mom trips out. Ever since my last friend that I ever physically had tried to stab me, and you know that didn't turn out too good. So my mom, as long as I'm living here, I can't really have people over.
With that, the priestess is gone. Her words ring in your ears. If I see you again, I will sacrifice every last hostage.
I'm getting tells right now. But we'll you know, maybe one day, Gore, you'd have a little puff, a little smoky. I don't know, it would be really great to be able... I really wish I had $20 right now. I'd be smoking. I try not to smoke on stream, right? I've been really good at that, right?
Oh no, I killed all the hostages.
They'll just propagate next time we come in here. I have no emotional connections to these NPCs. But like, there's a couple streams where I got on after a smoke. I'm not gonna lie. And obviously it's not entertaining. I'm just like really quiet. Sometimes I'm a little silly, but most of the time I'm quiet. And I'm just enjoying the game. Really focused. It's only when, like, back in the day, like, the idea of me being a funny stoner was from years back when I used to smoke every day, right? And so my tolerance was at the point where, like, I wasn't zoning out every time I smoke, and I was able to talk, right? Now, because I'm so broke, and I have so much shit going on in my life, when I smoke, I just zone out because it's like once a month, right? So I'm like, but before I'd be like, hey, what's up, you? Like, I'll just say all this wild shit. Yeah, you and I would have a lot to talk about if we smoked together. That's for sure. There's a lot of crazy shit that we can go through. Just like that time we were doing Underdark Arena challenge. A lot to say. Yeah, my uncle, Keck, my uncle makes these juices. So I never have to pay for juice. Though I probably should. I shouldn't take advantage of my uncle's hard work. But I do, because I'm broke. And he actually sold me, or he actually sells these vape mobs. And I'm not trying to say that I could, I'm not trying to be selling tobacco products online, you know, because they're real sensitive about that. But let's just say that I got the hookup. He tried to cast a spell on me, but I got all these immunities. He tried to put burning blood on me. Ooh. Fuck
We going to three?
Sorry, I got distracted. We're going to Unquiet the Graves. I'm just taking the dumb route. Yeah, we're going to two. I just have to find my way up the mountain. Oh, here we go. Waymouth, you're a Waymouth. Get your Waymouth. Waymouth, always win and go. Welcome. Only shooting barbarians. Break the mold. It's a cool place, and it keeps getting cooler. Yeah, like, cools I smoke on like Mueller. No, Bueller. Yeah. Ah, man. Why does life have to be alive? Is that ingrained? I have it targeted on my map, so I'm going directly there. It's just, I'm extremely east of there. They need a nerf inquisitive. pretty good. Pineapple Express is also a strain of weed, like in real life. And it's actually named after a Hawaiian wind current. And so a lot of that strain, like supposedly what I've heard is that that strain is grown in that wind currents. And that's just special. I had it once. Probably it was off seasoned or something because it wasn't super fantastical, or maybe I'm just so desensitized to THC and CBD products. Yeah. I just water. I just passed two things of water. Try to give Waymouth some time to catch up here. Only shooting dicks, blow your load.
They are pillaging this village for more than just supplies. You must not allow them to bolster their ranks. A drow necromancer is raising the dead. Not even death can. The wealthiest villagers, both here and in Evening Star, are buried in this section of the graveyard.
What are you gonna do with all the mobs inside your hogs? I'm gonna get you hurt, get you hurt. My mobs, my lovely drow mobs, check them out. You got me healing. Healing all this damage from you, from you. A remix. I just got a compliment from an old friend that just came back from the game. He's like, "You're more OP than I remember you." And I'm like, "Really?" Like, it's hard for me to hear that stuff because like I think I'm just like a regular player, right? I have a hard time acknowledging that I'm any good. But yeah, waiting game. Oh, he's here. So, like, when people tell me I'm OP and stuff, I'm like, but, like, in my head, I'm like, but you can do this stuff too. Like, you know? Like, there's nothing in this game that I do that no one else can do too. Right? All these past lives, all this, the way I play and all that. Matter of fact, I don't even play with the mouse, so you guys actually, I have a handicap compared to the rest of the server, if you really think about it. Because I can't do, like, I have to hit a button and I can't strafe. I don't play like this. I play like this. You know what I mean? Like, it takes me longer to turn. Yeah, right? Dude, I remember my first two deaths in hardcore. People send me like tells all the, and I'm like, how do you know I'm me? People are like, dude, how'd you die? I'm like, how do you know who I am? I was level 8 and level 9. Or I was like level 7 to level 9 when I died. It's not that fucking hard. That's like, I keep telling people, once you get past level 9, you're at the safest stage, right? You have most of your Gucci enhancements. Most of, you know what I mean? Like, you should, it should be harder to kill you on elite. I must say, on elite. R1's a different story. But right now I have Nikolai set up where I'm going to try to get Shiradi on him and as fast as possible. So that way I can get Shiradi on him as fast as possible. But the thing is that I need to set up his Epic Destinies and his Twists well enough where I can do Legendary Reapers on him. And I'm when Night Revels is over, I'm going to try in 12 days to get 400,000 Reaper XP and have all 5 rewards from Hardcore League. Because a lot of people has been getting on my case that I didn't do any of the Reaper stuff. And, honestly, I don't give a fuck. But it's starting to get annoying. So I end up having to, like, dab on these dads just to get them to shut up. You know what I mean? Dab on my dad. You know, if I don't do something in this game, it's because I don't want to, and I don't need to. But people are like, oh, you didn't do it, yeah. I'm like, bro, catch me on Serlona, how about that? Like, if you don't think I can, if you think because I didn't do it, it means I can't do it, meet me in Serlona, let me drip on you. I have 11 million RXP, I have almost all the past, I'll show you on a piece of paper what past lives I don't have, right here. I just redid it. Whoop. What's that? These are the epic past lives, right? There's like 12 of them. There's 5 iconics and 5 heroics. How big is your list, bruh? How big is your list? I can do it. I've proven it. I can do it. So all because I didn't do it doesn't mean I can't do it. Plain and simple. But you guys are pushing it, right? So 12 days, within 12 days, I could probably do it sooner than 12 days. I will get that shit. And then what? All you people who took weeks to do it.
The XP report always goes down when things happen, but you still get the full XP later.
Isn't that weird, though?
It is, but it always does that. It does that when you bring out a hireling, for example.
I remember people, like, tripping out because, like, the RXP in a dungeon would fluctuate like that.
You've begun to make a dent against the suffering the drow have caused. At least this one person will be able to start their life.
Wait,
over again.
Is there like a trick that I didn't know about?
She's definitely been through here. As you search through it, another
drow. Never mind, I'm live streaming, I shouldn't know.
Did you kill my companion? Good. I claim his slaves for myself.
Oh, you guys already did the first fight, I see.
Yeah.
I guess I'm too hot to handle.
People taken from the priest. A drow is ransacking through the scrolls, searching for something. Even though the goddess Mystra is long gone, the scrolls are still protected. The drow are plundering this temple for Mistress' secrets. They're looking for this thread of belief.
Do you think it's funny that in 4th edition they had this whole story about the Thread of the Weave and Loth as a dark elf, and she'd be like, where's my weave? No, I'm sorry, I had to go there. Hey, Hellman. I'm only ugly on the inside and the outside. Go Jimmy, go Jimmy. Go Jimmy, I like the things you do. Go Jimmy, if I could I would be. Huh? Disneyland? If you want to hit that lever inside there. And then bam. Magic. Like a black magic. I've been having an idea for a character and I wanted to walk it through with someone. Give it to me, Hellman. Hellman. Helmet. Helmet. Heel man. Down from the chamber ahead. Girl, what is the nature of your magic? What is Elmer's? What is this nature of your magic? It's called puberty. I'm getting too big for my kid clothes. I've been having some crazy character concepts too. As you know, I'm working on a campaign I want to run, specifically for my tier 2 subscribers. And one person tier 2 sub to get in, and I'm just waiting on a couple more and some setup. Fuck this. Yeah. That's what I thought, civilians. We got to Hall of Fame.
This was once the Grand Cathedral of Mistress Temple, where throngs of worshippers sang praises of the goddess of magic. Now the goddess is gone.
So this is like a necromancer? Walking up to a forest, has a bunch of corpses and same different armor. It's weird. This is a weird presentation of a character concept. Is Anna following me?
Thought we might find the thread of the weave here. Whatever it is,
All we found were more drow. If it were here, they'd have found it and left. Another rest shrine. If we get separated, let's meet back here.
You mean sorcerer? Yeah. I mean, the necromantic sorcerer line in 5th edition isn't super... super into, corpses. It's more like Alucard from Helsing. I think I need to change the coil out.
At the back of the ruined banquet hall stands a strange creature.
Fat ass. Okay.
A barrier appears in front of the dryder.
Okay.
You've done some serious damage to my slave operation here, he says. Fortunately, I have plenty of slaves.
So he's a guy with a family. He's a sorcerer. I wish they would make sorcerers more sturdier in 5th edition. It's such a... they're trying. But it's really hard to play sorcerer at low levels in 5th edition. Oh, what? You wanna fight? Just took chunks. Could be. I don't think that Eldritch Knight is a fighter path in 5th edition. If we're still talking about pen and paper, unless you're talking about short stories, then you could do whatever you want. But in 5th edition, Eldritch Knight is a fighter path. Sorcerers actually don't have a melee path as currently, unless you're talking about the dragon and origin, then they get claws, I think. But it's kind of silly. Homebrew is always an option, but there's no homebrew for that I know of. Like, you would have to sit there and recreate everything. It's probably, if you're going to do a spell sword, just do a fighter or arcane trickster. It's the same concept, and honestly, the fighter class is such a sturdy class that why not? You know what I mean? Like, at least you'll be able to fucking survive. I've seen sorcerers go down in their first fight on session one. I'm going to put an LFM up for this one and get it started.
I was running out to the Underdark. Or at least the portal guy who's near it.
Oh, yeah. I think I still have the portals from the last time I did this. It was a battle for Evening Star. Huh. It's not hard. You get spells, you get, like, the whole thing about Eldritch Knight is that it's an arcane melee, a gish. You know what I mean? The Oh, if you want a sentient weapon, go Warlock Hexblade. Because Hexblade pack, you're literally making a pact with a sentient weapon of Shadowfell. But you can actually, that's easy to homebrew. You could say, hey, because I made a pact with a sentient weapon from Argonessen in one campaign, and another one from the Feywild in another campaign. So where the sentient weapon is from doesn't matter. But if you just do Warlock, Hexblade pact, and also go Pact of Boon of the Blade, right? And if you choose your invocations right, you can actually make a really fun melee spellcaster. Well, the fighters aren't really as generic in 5th edition. As you could tell, they get Arcane Archer and Eldritch Knight. Those are fighter prees. And those are the most beautiful concepts in pen and paper, hands down. Also, yeah, no, the fighter in 5th edition is so far from generic. They can pretty much do... They're actually probably in the top 4 strongest classes. Up there with Cleric, Warlock, and, of course, Bard. Rogue's pretty strong, too. But, yeah, Warlock would give you... exactly what you're describing to me. And here's another thing a lot of people don't know about Warlocks, is that Warlocks don't necessarily have to make a pact with their pact. You know what I mean? It could actually be that they stolen it or siphoning powers. So they get their powers by either selling their soul or making a deal with a demon, a devil, a fey, a sentient weapon from an airplane, etc. and so forth. But another thing is that they could also discover this being exists. And let's say they discover it exists and discover that it's stuck in an eternal sleep. So it's siphoning and stealing its power to gain their magic. Or they're stealing the source of their its power. You know what I mean? So it causes really fun role-playing capabilities. I got the quest started. Is this R1? No, so think of classic deals, like Rumpelstiltskin asking for the firstborn, or the devil asking for your soul, or the deal can't be like, you get amnesia and then you get this weapon, like, unless you can write it where it's not amnesia, but your memories, weapon, or this being says, hey, I will give you myself as a weapon for your favorite memories. So, like, that would actually be really fun role-playing concept, too. So, like, you can kind of remember bad things in your past, kind of, sometimes. But all your good memories are gone because you sold them to the weapon that you have. And your weapon, of course, doesn't want to remind you what you sold it. Yeah, I'm liking this. But what would be his drive as a family man to do this?
Some of these are so slow.
I know, right? If you want to go on, I can handle this one.
Catching up with some old acquaintances.
For him to live, but you see where there's a disconnect, right? He's a family man who's selling his memories to a sentient weapon. For him to live, where does that come? You know what I mean? Like the when you make a weapon pact, you're asking something for a weapon to ability to smite something, not to live. You know what I mean? Like that would be a different kind of pact, indeed. But if you want a spell sword, if you want something that has a weapon or a sentient weapon of some sort, the goal shouldn't be to live. It should be to keep him safe. Like maybe he needs this weapon from a local baron was trying to kill him and steal his wife. Or and you know, possibly even kill the kid, so that way he can, you know, give his wife a new kid. You know what I mean? Like stuff like that. You know, if he has Walter White cancer, he isn't gonna ask for a sword. He's gonna ask for a cure. Yeah, no, that makes no sense. Like we were going down a really good path, but there's no way having a sentient weapon's gonna cure you from death's door. If you're gonna be a spell sword and have a sentient weapon and all that, the only reason you have a gun is to either protect yourself from something or to kill something, not to fucking cure your AIDS. So if he's at death's door, don't make it from an ailment. Make it from an actual sentient thing, right? Make it a group of local thugs express that they want to take his wife and stuff. So he gave his memories to the sentient weapon to have the power to drive these things away, right? So as soon as he got rid of the threat to his family and to his own life, his memories were lost, and the weapon randomly teleported him via Misty Step or something, which is a spell warlocks eventually get, right? It makes sense that their pact being, or is able to do it, to a direction, and he's just there, not remembering anything. That's just my opinion. But it makes no sense to, you know, be at death's door and ask for a fucking sword. Are you kidding me? If I was going to make a pact with an extraplanar creature or entity, because I'm sick and at death's door, it would be for a cure, not a weapon. A weapon ain't going to do shit for me if I'm dying. Alright, and he made a pact with a weapon to protect his village. This entity showed up as a sentient weapon and said, alright, but after the deed is done, I want your memories. And then after he stopped the raiders, he randomly wakes up in a random place, not knowing anything. That works. Alright, Death Undone first, right? We'll do Belly and the Beast when we come, turn in the first three quests for the portal opens. Or we can do Belly the Beast now. It's up to you guys, because I can do it whenever.
I never even do it. I always skip it, so I don't care.
Alright, we'll do Belly the Beast. Or not Belly of the Beast. Don't drink the water. That's what I'm talking about.
The water.
It's just so easy, I just go, you know, I'll do that later. So you want to do Belly of the Beast now? That one's not so hard on R1, as long as it doesn't bug. It's good XP too. Okay, let me. No, he knows that he has a, because he has a lock in. I love it now. But one thing I would change is that he doesn't know he has a wife and kids. He assumes that that's his wife and kids, right? If he doesn't remember anything and he has his locket. Freaking just be like, I think this might be my wife and kids. I might have to buy Reaper wings here to get all this gold. Yeah, I can't get all my gold. Can you guys give me a second? I gotta go pick something up. So, like,
yep.
And, you know, and he assumes that it's his wife and kids. And so this is where you have to be flexible with the DM. You go to the, you tell this story to the DM. The DM loves it, right? But what if you meet these individuals, right? And it turns out there's something else, right? Like, that way you give the DM some love. And you have a really good story, you have a really good drive. This whole time you think they're this, and if the DM wants to, if the DM decides to, he can pull the rug off of you, and then all of a sudden you send your, you know what I mean, like, you want your story to be malleable between you and the DM. Because remember, this is the DM story, and you're only playing a character in the story. It's like being in a play, right? But instead of the character, the roles being made for you, you make the role. And so the DM has to be able to also work with you as much as you working with him, right? Maybe the sentient weapon tells him a name that's not even his name. Maybe the name that you write down in his player character sheet is the name that his master gives him. And to his sentient weapon, he's just nothing but a pet. Right? So he's like, you're mine now. Your memories are mine. You're mine. And I'm going to call you Waldo. Yeah. Or something. So the name... Yeah. Yeah, the name that he knows himself by is only the name that his sentient weapon calls him by. I like that. I like that a lot. All right, I'm ready to head to Billy the BB. I had to buy it because I just didn't have enough room for not Schindlerlin. Get out of my way. Wait, do you need me to walk you there? Have you made it to
We're
Schindlerlin?
all right around here. Yeah, we both made it. We both went there.
Right, I'll walk you from Schindlerlin to Rizmalog or whatever it's called.
This is one of the gateways for which Schindlerlin has become known as the City of Portals. It leads to the furthest reaches of the Underdark, the surface realms, and beyond. The Drow regularly use such portals. Returning with dominating the center of Schindlerlin is an immense signal. The chasm ahead drops deeper and deeper into the Underdark, down into places that even the Drow.
Yeah, just go to Schindlerlin and I'll show you from there. Unless you guys can choose Riz already.
Nope.
Yeah, just go to Schindlerlin. I have all the teleportation, so I have to run to you guys because you guys are gonna be down here. And turn around and go into the thing.
The Drow have fought with mithril and magic to keep you away.
That could work. I mean, most sentient weapons are empathic like that anyways. So we're just gonna jump across to this this here ramp. I can show you. I hope I have enough jump for this. Oh wait, we don't need to jump this one. I have a real fear of falling from heights. I don't say heights because I could be pretty high up, but once I get close to an edge, I get this like fear of falling. Like falling scares the shit out of me. I probably have a fear of heights. If you want to be more generalized with the fear, but specifically, it's not being really high up that scares me. It's having the possibility of falling that scares me.
I'm following these footsteps.
That's what they're really good for.
It's weird.
That's up to you, bro. I always try to change the way I talk for all my characters. Like, Cup, I try to talk like deliberately with the words I say. And then for Niven, Wednesday in the first Sunday game, I talk really quiet.
Cheers and
Yeah.
catcalls echo dimly
That's really
off the
funny.
tavern walls. The
And
sound
then
of brave
the
spectators
Thursday
feeding
game's
the
like, oh,
feast
that's great, because I just thought that we could just walk right in. Why do we always have to do all this crazy shit?
These evil creatures must assume you're here by invitation, that you're as evil as they. It may not yet.
And then, I want to play a Lizardman, because Lizardmen are weird too, just like Warforges are. Where they'll be like, why are you so much clothes? Like, I kind of want to give them that, like, nerdy, like, give me my asthma sprayer. But, like, I don't know, try to make it more like Lizard, like,
jeez, your warriors are weak. Now prepare to face my dual blade.
If you want to do an accent, you have to, I say, practice the accent. Know exactly how you want to start it.
The bargain is struck. Your purple knights are free to leave.
Oh, I guess Thug Life.
Feral Kaverim shouts to the crowd. Why, he looks like someone fell into the
I like this quest because of the many ways you can do it, all the optionals and all, and the DM verbal prompts change for it. So you know whoever DM'd this had to sit in the voice acting booth for like way long, just pre-recording all these like situational things. I guess if you want. I think eventually things start coming at you up there though.
Yeah, it'd be terrible if your seat fell down on you though, but sure, have a seat.
It's totally up to you. Now, here's the issue, though, that this is where your role-playing might get a little spotlighty, is because only you can hear the thing, right? You're just going to be sitting there talking to yourself into, you know what I mean? Like, it's going to get a little, like, this guy's kind of like a selfish jerk when it comes to RP, right? You're going to be like, what do you mean? Holy crikey, there's a fucking weapon over, you know what I mean? Like, oh, only I can hear my weapon talking this funny accent. Like, what's the point of it being funny if no one else can hear it to enjoy it, right? You might as well just make it ominous, right? And what kind of name would your sentient weapon give you if it had a thick Scottish brogue? Like, okay, Wally, you know what I mean? Like, freaking Angus! Freaking! It's gonna take this really dark part of your character and just kind of confuse it, right? Then it becomes a little too much. Like, yeah, there should be some comedy in your sorrow, but this is really dark things. You know what I mean? A really dark thing to give up is your memories. Shoot, Wild Arms 3 was all about preserving memories. And another thing that kills me is that, like, Scottish is used so much in pen and paper. And honestly, like, does that world even have a place that has a Scottish accent? Right?
Well,
Like, at least in Critical Role, Matt Mercer tries to do different accents because maybe in his world, Scottish accents ain't really... There's no place that will provide a Scottish brogue, right? Like, everyone wants to do, like, oh, it's good. And also, it's slightly a little racist to be like, oh, the way Scottish people talk is hilarious. I'm like, they can't help it. They were born that way, you fucking jerk. Fucking. So, like, I have a lot of problem with, like, the whole Celtic brogues and how they're done. Like, even Nikolai, he doesn't do a straight Irish thing. He just can't say TH rights, and he has an upward inflection. So it's like, oh, 2 days before Thursday. He can't say TH, he can't say th. But a lot of people are like, oh, that's an Irish accent. I'm like, no, that's an English accent with an upward inflection and the inability to say TH. Scottish is funny. Say that to William Wallace. He would stab you in the face. That's racist. Are you saying a whole culture of prideful, freedom-fighting Highlanders is hilarious to you? Who had major plight? Are you saying the people who invented Dracula are funny? What that is called, in all literalness, is cultural insensitivity, and it makes you kind of a racist jerk. It's better to make it up, like I said. So 2 days before Thursday, that's not an Irish accent. That's just the inability to say TH, and that's how I do my accents. I don't start with a sound. I start with the inability to say something in English. You know what I mean? Like, I grew... My mom's South American, right? And I noticed that she speaks... She doesn't speak with, like, an accent because she sounds this. It's because she can't say certain things, right? Like, I had a drill sergeant that was Haitian, right? And he couldn't say, I fuck you up. He says, I fuck you. I fuck you. So, like, it wasn't really a sound that made him sound Haitian. It was the fact that he couldn't get certain words. I think of, like, the words that they can't say. So you can legit make your own accents by just fucking up English words. Like, what if your sword can't say W's right? And they, in it, instead of Willy, it's a silly. You know what I mean? Like, or Lily, it replaces W's with L's, right? And then that way, it doesn't have to specifically make fun of a specific culture. But it still has the comedic thing about not being able to talk right. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, see? Stewie has what people perceive to be an English accent. There's many different English accents. But really, it's just him speaking in a way where he's not saying words quite right. Right? Like, cool whip. Cool whip. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Cool whip. You know what I mean? Like, it's not necessarily an accent where you think of sounds. It's a structure of your mouth and the inability to say certain words. Like, res shrine. Like, I always tell, like, Voodoo, like, that, you know what they say, call shrines in France, shrine. You know, like, that's not true. Like, OPJ clearly doesn't say Shrine. He says shrine. Shrine. You know what I mean? So you can almost it what you call a parallel accent where it sounds like it could be from somewhere, but it's not. You know what I mean? Like, there's just so much you could do. Don't freaking be so narrow-minded as to think. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know if I'm making sense. I'm not picking up that thing. I like doing that though. Like, Nikolai is one of my favorite ones because it was like the first one I kind of started realizing stuff like that. Was like 2 days before Thursday. 2 days before Thursday. Like, there's no accent in there. Like, that's no. You talk to any Irish person, they don't sound like that. But it's parallel. And all it is an upward inflection. You point the tip of your tongue down, and you don't say th right. Oh, I'd put a splinter in my tongue. Your tongue? Yeah, my tongue, which is thumb. It's thumb, thumb. Yeah. And also, if you look at a lot of linguistic videos, you also realize that where you point the tip of your tongue and how you stretch certain sounds is really important too. So, like, if you want to point your tongue down, or if you want to put your tongue up, you know what I mean? Like, it actually changes how you talk and where you stress your syllables. You know? And it might, like, when you practice, you might not like, oh, that just does, that just sounds like me muddling up my words. But really, it's the slight difference. It's just like, oh, this is what I would sound like if I was from here. Like, your voice is always going to be your voice, but how you say things is always dictated by your original language. So, like, that's where accents has come from, is that you did not originally speak this language. So, because you spoke a different language. So that's another question. If my sword has an accent, then what's its original language? Why does it have this accent? Where is it from? If it, you know what I mean, and why would it be a Scottish accent if it's a Shadowfell weapon? Why is it, you know what I mean, like, it has to kind of make sense. 13 minutes, not bad. Daffy Duck was literally a lisp. Do you guys want the portal out here? It'll help you teleport to the middle of town. Cool. It was a wet lisp. Fucker, you know what I mean? Like Sebastian the cat. Alright, I'm gonna change the LFM. I'm gonna get the teleport anyways. Death Undone. That way I can just teleport in the middle of town. Also, you have to remember, most of those accents and characters were made during really prejudiced times. So, of course, the very sensitive, very annoying instigator was very, lispy, fuckering, fuckatat. Like, you know what I mean? Like, why is this guy so bothered by this bunny? Like, he has to be an anal intensive weak, you know, like more feminine, like, you know, let's just say Warner Brothers wasn't without its sin back in the 1930s, you know what I'm saying? Like, so most of the villains back then were either, there's some documentaries that will make you go like, what the fuck, about that time period, but anyway. But, like, you ever watch the animation for Daffy? They even got a little spit coming out of his beak, like, rabbit season, duck season, rabbit season, you know? So the key is the major starting part is how you pronounce words wrong. I'm telling you, this is when I started getting really into accents in D&D. Is what words am I gonna say wrong and why am I gonna say it wrong? Like th for ta. Maybe you can't say rt like t-shirt. T-shirt, t-shirt. It kind of sounds silly, but that's an accent, right? Freaking every time there's an RT, IRT or a URT, it's what? What about bucks? Buck. Oh, you mean Bugs? But like Bugs Bunny? He was a more teethy lisp. Remember, he was also a cross-dressing rabbit that didn't mind kissing a white man here or there. He was a very popular instigator. Powerful explosion destroys the library's archive, leaving the stone floor. I'm gonna make sure I have. I don't remember if they give you enough for the last two. But go ahead and start clearing upstairs. I'll be right behind you. Joker? Okay, so Joker doesn't have a singular voice. Remember that when we think of the Joker, we think of Mark Hamill's voice. And the way he does the Joker is amazing. But there was a lot of people who portray his voice differently. So the Joker. And canonically speaking, in the comic books, there's more than one Joker. Batman found that out through the Seat of Knowledge. When he asked it, you know, who is the Joker? So, I can't do the Joker. Like, I can only try. And it would be very embarrassing. But if you can, that's great. Another thing is, if you're gonna have your sword have an accent and all that, don't act it out. Just don't. Just be like, you know, the party was like, who are you talking to? And you're like, oh, my sword. He has a this accent, a that accent. He kind of sound and or make him. Try to emulate the accent badly, so in their heads they can picture this conversation. So that way you're not taking time away from the rest of the party, right? So you can be like, it's my sword. What, your sword talks to you? He's like, yeah, he says stuff like, oh, put on your short. You know? Oh, that looked like it hot. You know what I mean? Like, as an example. If you want to do the RT as WT, what? But emulating other people's accents is like, you can be, if you're creative enough to make a good background story, then, oh, whoops, I forgot to put the, I'll be right there. Okay, you got it. ID doored before putting the stones in there. But I got the completion. I'm like talking about accents in a live stream and like how to make your own. What if they could hear it, then maybe make your character a little bit more quiet and make your sword talk more for you. You remember, you don't, you, the reason why a lot of DMs don't allow people play two characters is because they take more of the spotlight. You don't want to be a spotlight stealer. You want everyone to be playing the game. Or you might as well just be DMing and playing with yourself in the middle of your room, right? Don't be an asshole. So either your weapon talks more, or you talk more. Don't ever take up more time than you have. If you RP, you should be RPing for seconds, not minutes. You want to be real, too. Like, for instance, when I meet someone, I don't go, hey, I'm plagued by this sword, blah, blah, blah. I'll be like, hey, I'm Willy. And then they slowly find out about me through seconds, right? Seconds spread along a thing. So if they can hear the weapon, that's great. But you don't want it to be you want to either talk less or him talk or it talk less. You don't want to take up too much of the player's time and make everything about you. And actually, I kind of like the concept of a person who's very submissive with a very dominating sentient owner. A weapon who he's like, what's your name, stranger? And then the weapon's like, his name is Willy. Don't feed him. He already ate. Like, oh, what the fuck? It's like, yeah. My name is Delvgoth. I'm from the Shadowfell. I'm a sentient weapon. And at that point, like, yeah, your character's your character. But also, It's RPs done through the blade, which kind of makes an interesting concept. It makes it fun. It makes it unusual, but it still doesn't give you the rights to double RP. Let's wait for Jimmy. Oh, Jimmy's here. Let's just fight him down here. I'm not gonna.
I'm here.
This is R1. We'll be able to smash him. Yeah, like if he's more subservient, like if he doesn't remember who he is, right, and all that, and the weapon's dominant enough, then the player, like that, I think that the DM would love that, would get a kick off that. It's like, this is such an interesting concept, where though you're playing with the character's physicality, right, you're playing with the character's stats and all that, but socially speaking, everything's through the sword. You know what I mean? Like, it's kind of like the a maw. That's gonna get me some money. Look at that drow maw of the weapon master. I'm gonna sell that to one of our wolves for a million plant. All those maw using wolf builds. Yeah. Or whatever. Like that, when I did will, it was for an example. Now, I mean, like you want the weapon to think of him kind of as a pet. He chose him, right? This is a way of means. He could, the guy doesn't matter. He could be, he could, this weapon could make anyone a hero, right? But they're symbiotically together. So at this, so the, every time he tries to talk, the weapon's like, shut up, I'll talk for you. Or you know what I mean? Like, he, and plus this guy is mostly a husk because most of his memories were taken. Maybe he'll have moments of RP where
Like the
he
other noble
you're like,
races, House
oh,
Aberfeyne
he looks
is
into his
proud
locket and
to
starts tearing up.
Sir Ziggurat.
And then the players are like, hey, what's wrong? And he's like, I don't know. I don't remember. And then that's like the few things that he says until his story starts unraveling, right? But leave it as a mystery, because it's a mystery to him, and how would he be able to unravel that mystery for the player? You know what I mean? And it also gives the DM fuel if he's running a homebrew campaign and not a module. See, another thing is, if you're gonna run a character like this through a module, it doesn't matter what his background story is. It doesn't, none of it matters. In a module, nothing matters except the module. I made the mistake of writing a complex, amazing, intricate, beautiful, romantic storyline for a character for a module campaign. And it turns out none of it matters.
You find yourself in the Aberfeyne's
When
Tower.
you run a module, just make a generic adventure
Appear to be just one
and
more
just
pawn,
shut your mouth and play.
waiting to be bound, forced into service.
We can pick the lock so we can avoid fighting. Or not. Fuck it. Thug life. Yeah, I enjoyed we're hammering it out with you.
The last of the captives have been freed, and a full riot is underway. Time to search for a way into the slave quarters within House Aberfeyne.
That's why next time I'm in a module, I'm gonna try to play Lizardman, because I don't want a complex Lizardman. I just want to be a Lizardman.
A guard captain investigates the racket.
I don't want to make up a story like a really intricate story. It's just like, I am a lizard man. One day, I discovered food quite fun to hang out with. So now I hang out with food. I mean humans. Right? Well, if he, it depends on the person. Like, judge it by person. If the person is as submissive as Willy, right? If he can grab him by the balls like he can Willy, then be a dick to him. Like, make him be a bully where he can smell weakness and he feeds off being a dick to him. But if they're very strong individuals, he's cool with them. That's how I would play it. And it's gonna be a sword? What kind of sword? In fifth edition, they got rid of bastard sword. Like pretty much, there's only just short sword, long sword, and great sword, I think. But if you're a Hexblade Warlock, At one point, when you get improved weapon pack, you can make that weapon anything, even a longbow. So it doesn't have to be just a sword. It could be whatever you want for that occasion.
Slaves stand beside large looms of spider
silk, sitting on the ground.
Fine garments for a noble brow. The slave master takes quick note of your bare breath. The slaves are free of them. The sound of skittering marks the next room as House Aberfool's silk farm. Slaves that have outlived their usefulness feed the spiders here.
Think of the Ninja Turtles, bro. They were like families, but one of them was a dick. Sometimes you know that you have a dick family member. Just play it by ear. Read the room. And if he's a dick, is he a dick because he likes to be dominant, or because he feels that he's smarter than people? Like, and figure, you know, once you figure that out, read the room, find the triggers. If something triggers the sword's dick mode, then play it off. Like, it could be a short sword, but like I said, eventually you can actually make your packed weapon be any weapon you want. If you have Xanathar's Guide to Everything and all that, you can actually be very diverse as a Hexblade world. One time, once I got improved weapon pack, you could even make your weapon, like, before, you can't make it a ranged weapon like a bow. But me, let's don't drink the water real quick before portal opens. I grabbed that shit and made it a longbow one time. And it's a pretty handy prestige because it's considered a magic weapon. Magic weapons are actually really hard to get in 5th edition because they're really powerful in 5th edition. The ability to break DR is really sought after. Well, it has to be a weapon, bro. No, you don't. Like, if you look in 5th edition weapons, there's no fucking yo-yo. Freaking, it has to, at beginning, it has to be any melee weapon. It takes an action to change it, right? But improved pact invocation allows you to make it a long sword or a crossbow or whatever. Magic yo-yo. I don't know. You would have to ask also, knowing that it's a yo-yo, you would have to waste your first turn every combat to change it into a weapon. You know that, right? You would have to send it off, make it vanish, and then summon it as a weapon. And it takes a turn. So, like, it's better just to leave it as a short sword and just, like, if I need a bow, I'll take improved pack, blah, blah, blah. And then, like, you know what I mean? Change it as needed. But know that it's not just a short sword. Short. Yeah. I'm just trying to zerg through this saga. R1's so easy.
Easy peasy.
Well, it's gonna be able to change into a spear regardless. And eventually it'll be able to change into a bow. Like, what I'm saying is that part of the Hexblade ability, when it has its blade boon, is that it could summon any melee weapon. Its packed weapon can come back as a mace, but it takes a turn to do that. So it's not this and this, it's a short sword that can become anything I want, and eventually, I mean literally anything, right? So like, if it wants to be a spear, yes. If it wants to be a dagger, yes. If it wants to be a greatsword, yes. That's not the problem. The thing is that if you take improved packed weapon, it'll also be able to turn into a longbow, which is dope. So like right now it could be any melee weapon you want, it just takes a turn, and then eventually it could become any weapon period. I need plus one weapon period with improved packed weapon.
One key appear, emerging from impossible high crevices of the edge.
Also, something up that's up to you. It has to sound freaking old or unusual, though. Like, you know, like Delta Fries or something like that. Because it's an extra planar sentient weapon that is able to grant you powers. Because warlocks get spells through their pact. That's the powers that are. And the invocations, right? So. Give it some mysterious name that sounds old and pretty freaking powerful. Call it Superman for all I care. Utara. I don't know, that kind of sounds like some jungle fighter to me. But yeah, Utara works. If you're gonna do the whole the guy's shy and the sword talks for him, try looking in the mirror and saying that to yourself. Come on, hello, I'm Utara, and this is Willy. He's my bitch. You know what I mean? Like, does it work? Then it works. If it, you know what I mean? Like, you have to like figure it out how it feels and sounds to you.
Yet another Yuan Ti barrier. You must be on the right track.
Utara. I don't know. It's a, like I said, it's up to you. Just practice saying some names. After this, I'm going to take a little bio break, and then we'll do the last four. Dragon has made this cavern his lair. That must be the source of the Yuan-Ti's poison. The great beast looks at you and speaks. The little ones promised wealth for this, but they said nothing sending me us. There's no need to rush. You know I've always told them to play with my food. Let's make an exception. You are testing my patience, small one. I will melt the flesh from your bones. Well, if that's what you think, then go with that. Alright, be right back, bio. Alright, well, yeah, that's what Willy could mean in her language, or Utara's language. I don't know, I don't really like Utara, because it makes me think of, it's, I don't know, it doesn't sound powerful. That's me. I could be way off. I could be pronouncing it wrong, because you're spelling it, it could be like Utare. Or something, I don't know. But I don't... Freaking... But the thing about making up a language, too, and what okay. means what, is that you could literally just be like, Willy means bitch in my language. Alright, I'm back, too. Portal opens, demon web quests, and actually I'm gonna take level 23 real quick. If you guys want to go ahead and step in, portal opens, I'll be there in two shakes of a trog's tail. I think I get any act now. Swimming fire elemental. It's so funny. It's hilarious. I wasn't planning to buy Reaper wings this life, but I plat cap too soon. Oh, wrong portal. Do I have portal opens? Let's go down. Down. Let's go down. Well, no, I should not go. 'Cause if everybody's doing it, does that mean that I can too? Oh, her eyes went down and cut you up. Nothing's like a dirty look from the one you want or the one you lost. The funny thing is, I can see in the Underdark until I'm playing outside and there's a freaking glare. That's the stairs. Okay, cool. And outside in my backyard, there's a ton of glare. So I have to play like this. Saluting you, DDO! Salute to DDO! An ache in your soul is everybody's goal. Right now, I don't have my phone with me, so I can't really see chats right now. But I'll get to you guys as soon as I'm done with this smoke. Are there other consequences other than deal when you go for Hexblade? No. You actually get a lot of benefits. You get medium armor proficiency. That's one. Chant it. I don't think you would chant a sentient weapon's name. You would chant a deity or, you know what I mean? Like, you have to read Hexblade. The sentient weapon bond. Sentient weapons aren't exactly super strong per se, but they're strong enough. You know what I mean? Like, they don't own their own realms. They're subjects to things that could probably give it a stronger pact.
With its protectors defeated, you might now take the ceremonial dagger.
Matter of fact, Yutaro would probably be a perfect name for the thing that made the thing into a sentient weapon. You know what I mean? Like, in Critical Role, the heck, Travis Wilhelm plays a Hexblade, and he got his hex, his sentient weapon from Kuotoa, or whatever. It was Kuotoa. Which is a sea like. Being probably a great old one, so the weapon itself didn't really have its name, but the thing that made it does, right? Am I going the right way? Yes. Come down and fight me, cow. Oh no, where's my death ward? Incendiary cloud, the blinder of the fire, Sorix. Spider Brooch, Spider Brooch, does whatever a Spider Brooch does. Can it swing from a web? No, it can't. It's a Spider Brooch. Watch out. This thing goes on your clothing. Probably should cure that negative level. Where is it? Okay, here. Back to the room I go. Back into the room.
The Tomb of Rolf lies before you, preeminent in its position high atop the gigantic Sycamore.
You're too late to stop my scrying, surface dwellers. Now I will find the thread of the weave and deliver it to Lolf.
That's up to the DM. I typically would play it like it is. Because resurrection just makes you come back to life, right? So it would still have your memories.
The thread of the weave is my gift to you. Now enter the portal, girl, and accept your gift. You cannot resist. Kill the surface. Now
weakling. You'll dare to bang. Alright, see you, dude. A high priestess may never bang.
I can't die like this. Please, please, not like this.
Alright, 3 demon web quests and we're... should be good. I'm surprised Voodoo's not on by now. Gives me time to get this delicious saga in. Has become known as the City of Portals. It leads to the furthest reaches of the Underdark, the surface realms, and beyond. The Drow regularly use such portals, returning with plunder and slaves. These last ones are 23, right? So that I can go up to 29.
Yeah, I think so.
Nobody wants to see the mirror, but it'll matter now. Cause I got do.
Hey, make my way out to Evening Star right now.
Hello. Getting a little orchestra going on here. Shit. I like to put the boogie, oogie, oogie. Damn, you got there. Oh, you have wings. That would explain how you got there so fast. Welcome.
Back into my work so soon, mortals. How interesting. It's a little late to try to finish what started back in Avalon. The drow have gathered all the dragon shards I need, but I could probably find a use for more. Perhaps I'll take the ones you're carrying in your bags.
I also find it interesting their use of Yugoloths in this game. Because those are Arcanoloths. Yugoloths have very many form. A lot of different looks.
Out, covering the realms and hastening the deaths of all who oppose me. How unfortunate for you that the words of Priestess Hecta went unheeded. She foretold of this very.
Yeah. Do I have enough jump? Nope. Oh, it put me above. Yes. You see that little thing going off my wings right there? That's because of the lighting situation here in the demon web. If you, yeah, there we go. You can, your wings, when those lights go through your wings, it forms a little cool thing. Alright. Thank you. I remember back in the day when I didn't know the direct route, and I used to just do all the puzzles and stuff and all the hidden chests. This quest in itself is a labyrinth of little fun things to do. We're almost at the end of Child by Fury in the Demon Web.
You're quite as feeble as you look, mortals. Come find me.
The Demon Lord Grugamith surveys his domain from his perch up on high. You'll need to find a way to reach him.
Hurry on over, we're at the end. I know, right? It looks like we're just waiting on Life Revoker.
Long last, you hold the arcane orb that
deal with the demon is next.
accomplished your mission and helped thwart the Spider Queen's plans. Though it's a dangerous thing to draw the attention of an angry god.
Give myself a hug. Oh, I hug myself. Just wanna love you. Give it to me, baby. 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 Someone died in the leaderboard ahead of me. And or TR'd. So now I'm back to like 22nd or 21st on the leaderboard.
Shattered remnants of some fallen kingdom rest between the demon web strands. Somewhere here is the ruins keep, the demon Kishnara, and more. To guard the orb entrusted him by Lolf, Kishnara fashioned three signs of power. While they hold, none may enter ruins keep. Several drow stand arguing before the first sign. With the faintest flicker, the sign moved. The sign of binding lies at the edge of the ruins.
I remember in first edition there was a module where you actually get to fight Lolf. And at first you look at her stat block and she wasn't that hard until you realize that she had a negative 10 AC back in Thaco days. That's like, what? Man, that was a very difficult
the sign
module.
And then is still.
You don't have to stay to fight these guys, you can just continue on.
Beyond the second sign, Ruin's Keep can be seen.
So I had a special set of the giant modules that led into the drow modules is that ended with you fighting in Lolf. And that was intense.
third and final sign has been undone. The Bugaloth waits for you by the plain door. Leave the doors to me, says Yindris. The demon Kishnara, champion of Loth, holds court in the Great Hall of Ruin's Keep. With the orb disabled, its power no longer.
Last but not least, fixing the rift. Ooh, tingle in my ear hole. When you get those web bridges, you can actually just walk here. I used to spend a lot of time here.
The path ahead abruptly ends,
so I can tell when certain bridges are up. I can tell if I can walk to a place or I have to hop into a place.
As if these forces were carefully placed to keep you from the rift between worlds.
Oh my god, my ear. Oh, it feels so good. Can do it, just in time to be right. You can do it, baby. Do it tonight. You can do it, and when you're doing it, you're doing it right. You can do it, baby. Do it tonight.
The depth of the abyss gapes between this ledge and the next. Magma bleeds from the veins of the rocks onto the ground below. A magical barrier suddenly appears, blocking access to the rift. A voice comes from behind and high above.
Such folly! What did you hope to find? Your world is bleeding, bleeding into the Spider Queen's domain. You cannot stop it. But since you are here, I will try.
Some of your life force fuses into the rift. It grows stiller and more solid.
It grows Ben Stiller. Yeah, I'm Ben Stiller. I was created from the rift between in the demon world. Ben Stiller, and there's something about LOLs.
Turns to fury as he looks a moment early and sees you healing the rift. The rift has been stabilized.
Very clever. Fixing the rift like that. And when she has consumed the prey,
the orb's power dissipates. Both defenses have been weakened. More important, Eberron.
Good job, y'all. You take a little break.
Yep, thank you for the run.
Nope.
Very, very good, very good.
It was nice playing with you for a more than just three quest, Jimmy.
Thanks. Talk to you later.
See ya.
Alright, thanks for the group.
No problem, see you around. Baby, you can do it. Take your time, make it right. You can do it, baby. Ow! Do it to them. Ooh, damn, you're so good. Do it, baby. Oh, that XP. That XP pouring on me. That XP pouring on me. That XP. Pouring on me. Rest stop. I stay at the end of the row. Okay, got you, bruh. I got you, son. What about you? Oh, you're heroic. Alright. You know what? Close my door. Don't need to talk to me. Baby, you can do it. Oh shoot, so that's two waiting on three quests. That's three waiting on these quests. See where Voodoo's at. Druid's Curse. Where's Voodoo at? Voo do 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 voo do 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 voo do 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 ginger. So I'm 2 levels ahead of that fool. Baby, you can do it. I can? Yeah, you can do it. Do re mi fa sol la ti. Do re mi fa sol la ti. Da. Alright, so I'm probably gonna call it quits here for now. Because I can't think of any way to keep it interesting. And honestly, like, if I look. Yeah, there's not many of you watching me. So what's the point of keep trying, right? You might as well give up. You know, giving up is what America's about. No, I'm just kidding. America! It's best not to try. It's what I thought to. Okay, so thank you guys for coming.